Hello and welcome to this sort of advanced black and white editing tutorial. Today I'm going to take this raw file and I'm going to turn it into a very interesting black and white picture like this, with really a lot of different shapes of contrast, of clarity. I'm going to concentrate on showing you how you can create dynamic and a lot of interest with different shapes and different contrast, clarity on different locations. So I'm going to start off here by just bringing it to black and white, of course, and just doing my basic thing, which is raising the shadows and bringing down the highlights. That is something that I love to do. It really gives you a lot of detail to work with, and I think the look is a lot better than before. So usually what I like to do in my black and white pictures is just to bring down the blacks and bring the contrast to the right, and I end up with a relatively contrasty, very dramatic black and white picture. And there's nothing wrong with that look, but I want to go a little bit different for this photo. So I'm still gonna bring down the blacks just a little bit, because that really just affects the very dark black portions of the picture, and I don't want it at the end to look too washed out. So I'm gonna bring down the blacks just a little bit, not as much as I would usually do, but instead of bringing the contrast to the right, I'm actually gonna bring it to the left. And the same with clarity. I usually like to bring that to the right, but this time I'm gonna bring the global clarity just a little bit to the left, like that. And actually I'm going to adjust the tonal curve regardlessly, even though that doesn't really have too big of an impact on the actual effect that I want to show you. But I'm still gonna adjust these sliders really quick in the tonal curve, just to make overall a little bit of a more interesting and more dynamic picture. Really no set tactic that I have here with the tonal curve adjustment. Just, you know, play around with the sliders and stick with whatever you like best. Alright, so now we have our starting point, and I really want to do a lot of local adjustments in this tutorial, because I want to add just some contrast, some clarity to some individual parts of the image. Now, first of all, I'm going to do a very broad adjustment, and that is with the graduated filter. And I'm going to just drag one over the front portion, and I'm just going to introduce a little bit of plus contrast and a little bit of plus clarity. You don't want to do this too much, otherwise the difference between foreground and background is a little bit too unnatural. But just a little bit, so you have a nice differentiation. Then I'm gonna grab another graduated filter and drag it over the very bottom portion of this photo and do even more plus contrast and even plus clarity in the very near foreground. So that way we already get a little bit of a differentiation, we get a sense of interest, and I want to increase that sense of depth of the picture even more. So I'm gonna grab another one and this time drag it over the background, so everything from this line and in the back is now selected. And I'm gonna go even more into the minus contrast and even more into the minus clarity. And here I'm also gonna grab another one for the very, very far background, and I'm gonna go even less clarity and even less contrast. So now we have a little bit of a more dynamic picture than before. If you see here, here's before, here's after the graduated filters. You see we have kind of a very sharp and very contrasty foreground leading into the kind of washed out background. And that's exactly the starting point that I want. And the next thing I'm gonna do is grab an adjustment brush. You could do this with a radial filter as well, but I just think the adjustment brush will be a lot quicker in this case. You want to make sure that you have your feather to 100. And first of all, I'm just going to increase the contrast and the clarity. And just kind of, first, before I do anything, look at the picture and see where do I want to introduce plus clarity and plus contrast. Where does some more interest needed? You know, where do I want to do that? So in this case, I think I'm just going to add some plus contrast and plus clarity on this train, maybe on just one side of this building right here, maybe on this building in the far background. and maybe add some more on the left part right here. I'm just kind of going in between those areas, add a little bit of plus contrast in some of these areas here in the tree and here on the fence as well, maybe on the left part even more, then definitely on these shields right here, these plates with the numbers. And I think, you know, here is before any of these adjustments with the adjustment brush, and here's after, so you see it's already a little bit more interesting. But I'm gonna grab another one and also introduce even more contrast and clarity, and sometimes even paint over the adjustments that I've already previously added. You know, you really can go with all kind of different strengths of these contrast and clarity adjustments, so you really get a lot of differentiation and a lot of interest, and you really can go very, very artistic with that. I think that already works pretty well, and maybe I'm gonna increase another clarity and contrast just for the sky a little bit in between those structures. So I like that look. I'm gonna go even further and even add another adjustment brush with plus clarity and plus contrast. You can go separately and just add plus contrast for an area, for example, as well, but I'm gonna do it relatively quick here because of course this is a tutorial and I don't really want to bore you with brushing over this image for 5 minutes. So let's just see before any adjustment brush and here's after, and you see it's a lot more interesting and we have a nice differentiation between the low clarity and low contrast areas and the high contrast areas and high clarity areas, and I definitely think that gives the picture a lot of interest and a lot sense of dynamic and differentiation. So I could go much further with it. I might just add a little bit more to the trees in general, but you know, if you're editing this for yourself, you can go really crazy with it and edit it a lot, but I'm gonna go relatively quick here. And as you see, the whole lighting scheme of the picture is kind of still a little bit too flat and a little bit too boring. So a way that I like to adjust this is just by grabbing another graduated filter and just drag one over the sky and make sure that it's a very soft edge, and maybe angle it slightly so it looks even more interesting, and just go a little bit into the plus exposure. You don't want to do this too much, but just a little bit. And then adding another graduated filter and maybe drag it over pretty much in parallel over the other side of the picture, and this time go a little bit of minus exposure, that way you really get the sense of depth and the sense of differentiation even more with just exposure alone without any contrast or clarity even involved. So another thing that I think is very important for a black and white picture is vignetting, and you can go do that by either just going down to effects and adding vignetting there. And I actually think I'm just gonna do that here because I think it works well, just to add a little bit of global vignetting, and you see here before vignetting and here is after, but I wanna go even further with it and add some more local vignetting on just some portions of the image rather than on all of the corners. So I'm gonna grab yet another graduated filter and drag it over the very, very bottom of this photo and just go a little bit into the minus exposure just to kind of close out the picture. And I'm gonna grab in an adjustment brush and go minus exposure with the adjustment brush to add even more minus exposure on some of these corners. And if I press O, you see I've really just added a little bit more vignetting over the left and the bottom portion of the image because I really don't want to add any more to the sky. So let me just quickly show you in the history before any vignetting. Here is before any vignetting and here is after, and you see it just looks a little bit more dramatic. And actually I might even add another graduated filter for the sky, a little bit smaller than the previous filter with plus exposure, and just add some more plus exposure over the very top right corner so it looks even more dynamic. And I really think the last thing I'm gonna do here is just to add some dodge and burning. Dodge and burning, I love to do it with the rail filter. You could use the adjustment brush as well, but I just personally prefer the rail filter. So I'm just gonna drag a loop shapes rail filter over the scene here. And first of all, go into the plus exposure. Dodge and burning is just making the visual parts brighter or darker, and that way you really can create even more dynamic, even more interest, and complexify the lighting scheme. So I'm just gonna turn it, and I kind of wanna go along these rails, and maybe even go a little bit more into the plus, and just drag it one over here, make it a little bit bigger, then right click duplicate and drag it over the other portion of this picture, and just make all of these areas that are still kind of boring and a little bit flat a little bit more interesting. Plus exposure right there. Usually I skip this procedure, but I really want to go show you every single adjustment I do and really explain to you why I put these radial filters where I put them. And you see, already I'm not done yet with radial filters, but here is before any radial filters, here's after. I've already complexified the image quite a bit with additional lighting. Maybe one more over here. You can go in different sizes. You can really make some small ones just for very small portions of your picture. Then of course adjust the exposure if it's a little bit too much for a certain area. Right click duplicate, maybe one more over here, make this one a little bit bigger, one more in between right there. And you know, you really can spend a lot of time doing this. I'm once again gonna do this relatively quickly. Maybe one more over there and another one right here. Right click duplicate, maybe just over this part right here. You can also do it in the sky if you wanna create some more interest in the sky and some more differentiation. Right click duplicate, maybe a bit of a bright spot over there. And I'm gonna do a few more plus exposure filters, then I'm gonna switch into the negative exposure filters. Just wanna add some more plus exposure on this tower and maybe on this train right here. But I really want to make sure that it's very subtle and not really noticeable once you are done with it. You know, you don't want to do it something like this where everybody knows you added something and it doesn't look natural. You really just want to complexify the light without really making it seem unnatural. Just adding a little bit of interest that your viewer doesn't even necessarily notice that you've added something there. And maybe a last plus exposure on this rail right here. So here is before any rail filters or dodge and burning, and here's after. It might seem a little bit obvious at first, but once you look at the picture for a few seconds, it really should start to look natural. And you see it's already a lot more differentiation, a lot more interesting. But I am going to add some other rail filters, but this time I'm gonna go into the minus exposure and also do this exact same thing as I did with the plus exposure filters, but this time just kind of put them in between and making some darker areas even darker. You know, it's kind of a sort of contrast. It really is a very, very powerful tool, and you really can create so much interest with it. Maybe another one right there, one in between these plus radial filters right there and there. Right click duplicate again, make this a little bit smaller to of course fit the area. Right click duplicate, maybe bring one over there and go even further into the minus. You of course can mix those with plus contrast as well. But just for the sake of simplicity, I don't think I'm gonna add any contrast. I'm just gonna stick with exposure. But you really can get fancy and mix some of the shadow, highlight, contrast, or clarity sliders with the exposure adjustment to really get the very refined and very detailed, perfect look, that it looks exactly how you want it to look. So I'm gonna finish this up very shortly here, just adding a few more, maybe one more over here, make this one a little bit smaller, right click duplicate, and maybe one more on this window right here. So then what I usually do is just look at the picture and see if there is a spot that is a little bit too dark, a little bit too bright, and then just adjust it. And that's why I love the radial filter, because you can just go to a radial filter that you've added and then adjust the exposure afterwards. Whereas with an adjustment brush, you really would adjust all of the areas that you've added with a single adjustment brush, if that makes any sense. But I hope you get what I'm saying. You know, here for example, this portion might be a little bit too dark, so I really can adjust that. And also, a thing that I like to do is just finalize it and maybe see if there's a final area that still needs a little bit more interest. And I think this part right here of the rails could use a little bit more plus exposure, and maybe I'm even gonna mix that with plus clarity in a second right here, because I really like the texture to be a little bit more pronounced there, and add another one over these trees right here, and also add a little bit of plus clarity and a little bit of plus exposure here to really get the exact look that I want. And I'm also gonna add another minus exposure filter right here. So this is not perfect at all, because you really can spend a lot of time in it, depending on how in depth you want to go with it and how perfect you want the look to be. But I think I'm done here for this picture. It already looks pretty good. Here is before any radial filter adjustments, and here is after. Once again, it might look a little bit obvious at first, but once you look at it, you will start to notice that it really looks a lot more dynamic and a lot more interesting than before. So I really think I am done with this picture right here, and this is just one look you can go for with your black and white pictures. And I really like the plus clarity and plus contrast look as well. You know, it has a very dark and very dramatic feel to it, but I just wanted to show you sort of a different way to go about editing a black and white picture, and really just add a lot of local adjustments and really add a lot of local plus clarity and plus contrast. And I think that way you can get a very fine picture, but you can still add some dramatic effects where you really need it. So, you know, if you really want to spend like an hour on your editing, you can go crazy with it, maybe even add some more graduated filters over some parts, and really just fine-tune your picture to where everything looks exactly how you want. But I think I made the point here. You get what I'm saying, you get what I'm trying to tell you, and hopefully you find it interesting and may be able to use it in your own editing. So here is the before picture before any adjustments, and here's the picture in black and white, just converted to black and white, and here's it after all of these adjustments. And I definitely think it's a very artistic, very interesting picture, and we really kind of emphasize this sort of rainy, very darkish, yet very artistic and fine mood. I'm not quite sure if my words made any sense there, but I really think the picture ended up pretty good. So as always, thank you very much for watching. Be sure to check the description down below for more black and white tutorials. I'm gonna link my playlist with all of my black and white tutorials right there. And if you would like to see more videos just like this one, landscape edits, also color landscape edits, of course, then be sure to subscribe. I upload one photography-related video every single day of the week. And also, if you like this video, please leave me a thumbs up. It really helps me out a lot and really helps to grow the channel. And lastly, but not leastly, I of course want to wish you a great day. Go out there and take some awesome pictures. And as always, take care.